is to prove it wasn't
her profile. Oh, wait a minute. Is it? Ah, there we go. Okay. Hey, let's see the full conversation.
What is this other part? Is it the right hand? Or the left hand? Maybe the right foot? Or perhaps the left foot? Or could it be the hips?
Her most noticeable feature, the tattoo that marked her membership in Fenrir. That was the right hand. The tattoo in the area was easy to spot.
You never saw their face, right? So you can't have any idea who was under that mask. I'm telling you now, it was Mukuro Ikusaba.
You're wrong.
I feel like I'm
going
to flip this.
Face, there's another part of the attacker we can use.
Like,
to
use the right hand to attack Mukuro.
Oh?
Let me try this.
And what is this other part? Is it the right hand? Or the left hand? Maybe the right foot? Or perhaps the left foot? Or could it be the hips?
I was hoping I can get that right in time and just speed him up a little bit.
You never saw their face, right? So you can't have any idea who was under that. I'm telling you now, it was
No, that's wrong. Mukuro had a tattoo on her right hand, if I remember correctly.
Mm-hmm.
A representation of Fenrir. In other words, a wolf tattoo.
Now that I think about it, I had looked at that tattoo thinking that it was a rub-on tattoo, but if what Willow is suggesting and its makeup, that means that the makeup is still on the tattoo.
But I saw the right hand of the person who attacked me. And there was no such tattoo. So there's no way the person behind the mask was Mukuro.
Spork, SJ, yeah.
Yeah, well, okay. You got me. I guess it wasn't her.
Monica was like, oh, well, shit. I got my pants down. Oopsie.
But that still doesn't prove that it was me. It could have been, you know, someone else, right?
Hiro, Toko, Hina, and I all have solid alibis for that entire night.
Yeah! We were in the gym tearing you apart, so it couldn't have been any of us.
Oh, okay, sure. It couldn't have been any of you. But what about Kyoko? It totally could have been her.
Yes, but she came in to fight, so why show up after and make it look like she's the hero? That doesn't add up there, Buttercup.
Uh-oh! No snappy comeback. Did I score a bullseye?
If you insist, I don't mind showing you.
Well, she gonna drop the hammer.
Huh? Show me what?
What do you think? I'll show you the one thing that proves beyond a shadow of a doubt it wasn't me.
Before anyone could say anything. Her hands. Holy sh! Queen, hey, morning. I'll show you my boobs. No. That's for later. Yeah, that's the happy time retreat. Kyoko was removing her gloves.
Your hands.
Without thinking, I let out a gasp. It was more than just a little burned
awful,
skin.
Awful, isn't it? It happened when I was first learning to be a detective. I was inexperienced.
What did you do? Put them in an oven?
I thought you didn't want anyone to see those scars.
If it means we get another step closer to unmasking the mastermind, it doesn't really bother me.
Yoko seemed to savor the words as she said them. Then she put her gloves back on.
My scars should suffice as proof. Makoto, did the person who attacked you have scars like mine?
Acid scars. She went after the Joker. That actually makes sense.
Not at all. I'm positive.
Then this much has been made clear.
Oh my god, when you really think about it, the easiest way for the killer to have fixed that is to either replicate gloves or have gloves in general on, but they don't screw it up.
There can be no doubt that the one who attacked Makoto is the true mastermind.
This is just awful!
Gameblader, hey buddy! Morning!
On top of my secret being revealed, I had to look at those positively grotesque scars of yours! Sorry, did I say that out loud? I do hope I didn't hurt your feelings.
Not at all. You can say whatever you want.
Sure, as long as it means pushing me farther into the corner, right?
Oh no, wait, I don't care.
Just yet, because if you haven't noticed, the circumstances surrounding Mukuro's death are totally unknown.
Am I liking it? I'm really liking it. It's good. I'm looking forward to playing Dakarampa 2.
That's true. All we know right now is she was killed a good while before this morning.
On the contrary, we don't know anything other than that.
You're not going to tell us she was already dead before we arrived here or something, are you?
In that regard, you have nothing to worry about. I promise you, without a doubt, she died after our little killing game began here.
Then somehow, she was killed in secret without any of us knowing.
And after she died, who knows how much time went by before we found her, right? Did the culprit stash her somewhere? She couldn't have been in the garden the whole time, could she?
If she was, she would have been totally decomposed. Just like your brain!
Then, she was being stored somewhere?
But...
give it time, give it time.
Here,
wait, do you have them in Discord?
Store it somewhere?
There's only one place. I can't think of anywhere else. Clearly the kitchen. Clearly the kitchen, right? I mean, the pool's a good backup, but look at that kitchen, Chad.
Mukuro's body was probably kept hidden in the bio lab.
The bio lab? You mean on the fifth floor?
If you want to throw them into creative, yeah, go for it.
That's right. It's actually set up for use as a morgue.
I'm pretty sure Hiro's gotten used to it. He just takes the lickings.
So it's the perfect place to hide a body. And it'd keep the body preserved at the same time.
I mean, Moha, to be really fair, it worked for Hansel and Gretel. I mean, that was a couple hundred years ago. It could work for modern times, too. Yeah.
Then you're also saying the body was moved from the bio lab to the garden.
And I have no doubt that that's exactly what happened. In fact, I have proof.
The proof that shows the body was carried from the bio to the lab garden. There's something that made its way from the bio lab to the garden. The orb.
I got it! What makes me so sure the body was carried from the bio lab to the garden is... the tarp that we found in the garden. When I was checking it over again, I noticed something. I noticed that some text had been stamped on one corner of the tarp.
Oh, it says Biolab.
Holy cow! How'd you notice that tiny little
cute
thing?
SJ.
Makoto's nitpicky nature seems to have surfaced with perfect timing.
Wait, nitpicky?
This proves that the tarp originally came from the Biolab. In fact, there's a whole stack of tarps just like it in there.
So when the killer moved the body to the garden, they must have grabbed a tarp to wrap it in. Then they simply left it as it was to protect against the sprinklers and put the code on it afterwards.
Well, to be really fair, Essie, Hina forgot that Monokumo had a control center. I mean, if it was Hiro, I'd back that. But then even Togami forgot. I think they're still affected by amnesia. Like, that's the only thing that I can canonically, through story, like, explain. They're just general, like, memory lapse every so often. Just going off, completely intelligent, all of a sudden, dirt. And then, I'm back. I'm good. It's the only way. Only way, chap.
Wow. You made everything sound so amazingly consistent.
That's just a wild guess.
I mean, it could be a symptom.
Where's your evidence? Prove that the body was wrapped in a tarp and moved.
There is no evidence. I was simply explaining what I think happened. But you seem to be getting pretty worked up about it, wouldn't you say?
Ooh, somebody's cornered.
Worked up?
Now that the conversation has turned to the topic of the biolab, you must be getting pretty nervous. Because the key to uncovering your secret identity is hidden within that room, isn't it?
Oh, so she figured it out.
Are you talking about unmasking the mastermind?
You see, the biolab contained an inconsistency. One so major it can't be overlooked.
An inconsistency in the biolab? Would you be talking about...
La la la, I can't hear you! La 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 la!
La 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 la!
Such a child. Oh well, just ignore him.
I need to pull myself together and think. In the inconsistency in the biolab... Could you be talking about...
By the way, Makoto, what about that one thing?
What one thing?
What do you think I'm talking about? Your family.
Nani? Well, I haven't thought about that in a while.
Don't tell me you forgot about that video message.
A little bit.
So what do you think? Are you sure your family's still okay?
Why are you bringing that up now?
Your mom, your dad, your little sister. What do you think has happened to your family? Are they really as safe as you might have assumed?
Stop talking about that!
Calm down, Makoto. He wants you to get upset.
I need to calm down. I can't let him get to me. He's just saying that because he knows we're getting close to the truth of the biolab. So if I want to shut him up, I need to expose the inconsistency and slam him with it. Has to be that one area where the numbers just don't match up. The fact that there aren't 10 bodies, there are 9 bodies? 1, 2, 3 dead bodies. Oh!
Are you sure about this? That's impossible! Are you sure about this? That's impossible! What do you want? Are you sure about this? That's impossible! Are you sure about this? That's impossible!
Final strike!
I'm not listening!
This should prove it.
So, I didn't realize there was going to be multiple choice on that, and I got that right by accident.
The consistency Kyoko's talking about is... the lights!
Ooh, okay.
What are you talking about? What about the lights?
Like I said before, the biolab also acts as a morgue.
It's condensation, not
that,
perspiration.
A giant refrigerator was installed in there. That's where everyone who's died is stored.
Because I'm assuming he's metal and not, like, furry.
And it was set up so that when a slot had a body in it, a blue light would turn on.
In other words, if the blue light is on, that means there's a body in that slot.
Hypothetical. Would it actually sense the weight of the body and therefore turn on, or could you just throw something in there? That way it just shows 10, because if they're not gonna check to see if there's anything there, that would have thrown a huge ass wrench, right?
But I counted up the number of blue lights that were on, including the one Mukuro was in. And there were only 9.
Oh my god. Kid, I forgot about that, brother. Oh, you're right. Now watch, the one above Mukuro, like one of those, it's not on because there's just not enough pound there. It's not enough pressure, right? Or, oh god, it's just an empty container of butter because Monokuma used it all up for the pancakes, chat. Can't have pancakes without a lot of butter. Everyone knows that. Ew!
Why does that matter? You gotta give me the bite-sized version here, man.
Oh, too soon. Oh, too soon, man. Too soon. Too soon. Too soon. Okay, sorry. Just for Hero. Mondo bite-size. Gotta have a Mondo bite-size. 9 lights doesn't make sense. The number of lights that should be on is... You're kidding me, game, right? I mean...
I got it. 10 of the lights should have been on. Any other number is incredibly suspicious.
Math checks out.
God, that's simple. Just recall who's died here so far, and it should become clear.
That's right. That's the key to solving this mystery. Sayaka died first. Then Junko was second. Leon was third. Chihiro was fourth. Mondo was fifth. Taka was sixth, and then Hifumi was seventh. Celeste was eighth. Sakura was 9. Kuro was 10.
So 10 people in all?
That's right. Any other number should make you immediately suspicious.
Oh, something that would be so insensitive. Like, if somehow... Mastermind's like, okay, so I cannot fit Hifumi in one of these containers. We'll cut him in half. And so somehow there's like 12 or 11 containers being used. Just throws the player for a huge-ass loop. And they're like, wait, why? Where's the extra body coming from? Oh god, sorry.
But according to
sorry.
The lights in the bio
morbid
lab,
idea.
Only 9 people were being
bad way,
stored
bad.
There.
You're saying a dead body just up and disappeared?
I'm saying it's a ghost, Hero. One of us is a ghost. We will suck out your soul through your nose.
I got it! The mastermind destroyed one of the bodies to get rid of evidence.
But if they wanted to do that,
you're right. Super problem
they
solved.
They would have destroyed Mukuro's body, since they actually killed her. And yet, her body was left alone.
Then, whose body disappeared? It may very well be.
A little bit louder than I wanted.
None of them
turn that down.
But if that's true, then why doesn't the body count match?
Including Monokuma's executions, there have apparently been 10 deaths, but there were only 9 bodies. That's the point I'm trying to make.
Let's be fair. Once you kill Hiro, his hair will find another victim. It's like the thing. John Carpenter's the thing. It separates to go find a host.
I'm completely lost. How can the number of victims be less than the number of murderers?
The reason there are less bodies than murderers, the explanation for one more murders than victims, Why is that? What would make it tick for them? Same person was killed twice? Sort of body. There were only 9, actually 10 murders, but 9. That's why there are 9 bodies. That's patently untrue. Oh, okay. So counting Monokuba's execution. Oh, sorry. I screwed that up. Actually,
shoot.
I screwed that up. Hey, let me look at that one more time. Same person was killed twice. Yeah. What I looked at it and my brain went, whoop.
The same person was killed twice.
There's a reason I have a ponytail, Chad. If I were to show you my hair, you would realize that Hiro actually did lose his hair, and I'm in the future. It's currently controlling me. Send help. And hair gel.
Huh? Killed twice?
Officially, 10 murders have been committed so far. But one of the victims may have been murdered, and then murdered again.
Murdered again?
If that's the case, there could have been 10 killings.
It's got to be able to taint stupid, Queen.
Right?
Yeah.
Technically, you're right, I guess. But still, something like that
could easily have happened. No, it is what happened.
Sounds like you're already convinced. Then can you tell us who was killed twice?
It was Mukuro, of course.
Okay, so we are going that route. So Junko is actually the mastermind. So then, here's the thing. Was Mukuro pretending to be Junko, or did she get an extra dose of getting dropped on her head to then make her think she was Junko? Either she's an accomplice because she is an agent of despair, and maybe Junko got fed up with her? Maybe? But then why would Junko attack Monokuma knowing the rules that it, should you attack, you will die? Unless she did it... Oh my god, she did it for the cause. It was... She's a zealot. If they are both ultimate despairs, then the idea that her sacrifice would help in such a thing. Crazy is as crazy does, chat.
Before she was killed as Mukuro Ikusaba, she was killed as someone else.
And that's why the body had to be stored in the bio lab until the moment we found it in the garden.
No, that's crazy talk. She was killed as someone else? Come on! Besides, who could that someone else even have been?
All you have to do is look at those bodily injuries of hers, and that will become obvious.
She did, but she had known the rules that if you attack the headmaster, you'll die. So I'm thinking she did that as a sacrifice. Because if they're both ultimate despairs, she gave her life for the cause. To ensure despair for everyone else in the group. That's the only thing I can assume that she would do, willingly and knowingly, that if you harm it, you're gonna die.
Nothing's gonna become obvious! Because Kyoko's totally delusional!
Ooh, someone biting their nails. The corners are slowly coming in, Monokuma.
Who is this someone else that Mukuro was killed as? Was it Sayaka Maizono? Junko Enoshima? Leon Kuwata?
Oh god!
Chihiro Fujisaki? Mondo Owada?
But let's hear the whole thing first.
Ishimaru? Kifumi Yamada? Celestia Lu? Whatever? Or maybe Sakura Ogami?
No.
There's no way anyone was murdered twice!
Murdered twice, Junko. Mukuro died from the wounds she had all over her body. Wasn't there someone else who suffered the same sort of injury? Yes.
Who is this someone? Was it Sayak Junko and Oshima?
Yes!
No, that's wrong.
Junko. Wasn't her fatal injury pretty similar to Mukuro's?
What do you mean?
Well, remember what happened to her? She was impaled by a bunch of spears all over her body.
Her eyes, chat. Look at her eyes. The reason why we haven't seen Junko's eyes is because her eyes are red. I'm calling it now. Her eyes are red. Okay.
And Mukuro died from a number of wounds across her body. When you compare that to the stab wounds Junko suffered...
Can the similarities match?
Yes, and those are the only fatal injuries that match up. That explains why those two bodies are actually one and the same.
So let me see if I have this straight.
Actually, now that I think about it,
Junko, or someone going by that name,
what eye color does Soko have when she's Soko? Spears.
Then her body was kept in the bio lab for however long before being dragged out again.
Because Celeste killed, she had red eyes. If Junko has red eyes, and Genocide Jill has red eyes, that means that all the killers have red eyes. Maybe I'm wrong with that.
Only this time, it was presented as the corpse of one Mukuro Ikusaba.
Wait, Leon had orange hair, but what color was his eyes? Were they red or reddish?
It all matches up, right? Those wounds Junko suffered could easily be these same injuries.
It's really true? Mukuro and Junko are the same person? Wait, so then... What does it all mean?
It means that there haven't been 10 victims, but 9. Which also means that among the people we thought were dead, one is still alive.
And that's the true identity of the mastermind?
Who is it? Who's behind all this?
We already know the answer to that. It's Mukuro.
Tucko's eye color
He's
is
still
normal.
Alive. She took Junko's body and made it look like she was the one who died. So Mukuro is still alive. She's gotta be. A little silence? Then I must be right. I'm right, aren't I?
Mukuro alive. The one that's alive, still alive, is Mukuro? But... Leon had blue eyes. Blue-gray eyes. Okay. Can we really believe that? No, there's no way. There's no way Mukuro Ikusaba, however you pronounce the last name, is still alive. Check the vitals! Uh-oh. Mukuro's fatal injury.
The body
I'll
was
see here.
Found in the garden. It wasn't Mukuro.
Then she's still alive?
That's right. She made it look like Junko's body was her. So the mastermind's true identity is Mukuro.
What do you say, Monokuma? Do you give up?
I love how that's an option. For that to be true, then that couldn't have been her body we found in the garden. Is that really possible? Hold on, I think
the
it's Mukuro's profile,
found
right?
In the garden. It wasn't Mukuro.
I think that's wrong. Yep.
No, that's wrong.
No, the body we found in the garden was
Oh, dental
Mukuro.
Records would be
that's
amazing.
That's one thing we can be sure of.